Alzheimer's, ALS, and Parkinson's, just some of the side effects of being exposed to toxins called BMAAs. Now, the toxins are found in blue-green algae. The University of Florida is trying to figure out if breathing it in is harmful. NBC2's Victoria Reslow is with the Cape Coral News team and was alongside researchers today. This is frightening, Victoria.
Now, although this water may look clean from afar, when you actually get up close, if you can look right here, you can still see some blue-green algae floating on top. Now, researchers aren't just interested in water. This is one of the spots where they're hoping to catch air off of bubbles and waves to see if there are harmful toxins inside.
Right down 2946.
Dr. Larry Brand with the University of Miami is looking for two specific toxins in the air, microcystin and BMAAs. Both are in blue-green algae.
This cone is to protect it from rain because we only want air.
This device can catch air that comes off waves breaking. Brand says the effects of microcystin and BMAAs are different than the respiratory agitation people can experience with red tide.
These neurodegenerative diseases take 10 or 20 years to develop. So you could be exposed now, but not actually come down with the diseases until 10 or 20 years later.
Those long-term effects could be liver disease, liver cancer, Alzheimer's, and Parkinson's. Neighbors who live along this canal say it's concerning.
I would think it would have to have some kind of a detriment effect on it.
I'm 76, so it's not going to affect me, but I wouldn't be wanting to raise my children here in that environment, I would put it that way.
Dr. Brand tells me people have died from eating BMAA in their diet, and now they're trying to figure out if breathing it in could be as detrimental. He's also taking samples not only from here, but also in Fort Myers, as well as all along the Caloosahatchee River. And whatever he finds, he plans to take back to the lab at the University of Miami. Live in Cape Coral, Victoria Reslow, NBC2.